Hey guys, so this problem deals with volume of a hexagonal prism here. So let's go through this problem and see what we are looking at. So this says that we need to find the weight of 1200 hex nuts, each 1 centimeter on the side and 0.5 centimeters thick, with a hole 1 centimeter in diameter. And one of these hex nuts has a density of 7.7112 grams per centimeter cubed here. So this is what a hex nut looks like here. So what we're gonna have to do is we're gonna find out the volume of this one hex nut and calculate the weight of it. And then once we have that, we're gonna multiply it by 1,200 of them, since they want us to find the weight of 1,200 of these hex nuts. So there is not a formula for the volume of a hex nut. So what we're gonna have to do is we're gonna have to break this down a little bit using formulas that we do have. So if we do not look at the center of this and pretend that this was solid, we would be looking at a hexagonal prism. And the first formula that I have right here in front of me, this is the formula for the volume of a hexagonal prism. Now this hex nut has a circular center, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna find the volume of that circular center and we're gonna remove it from the volume of our hexagonal prism. And that's going to give us the volume of what this nut is. And then once we have that, we're gonna calculate it, or we're gonna multiply it by its density here and multiply it then by 1,200 of them. So the first thing that we need to do is find the volume of the hexagonal prism. So this formula here says that this is the square root of 3 over 2 times side squared times the height of it. Now for the purposes of this problem, what we're going to need to also keep in mind is when it comes to the side of this hex nut, this is a hexagon, and the side of the hexagon is 1 centimeter. What we should also know about a hexagon is that all sides are equal. So every single one of these 6 sides here is 1 centimeter. Now the height for this particular problem, we need to kind of be a little bit visual here and keep in mind that the height of this, if this hex nut were actually laying down, that's what the height would be. So it would not be the height from like point to point or something like that. This would be laying down, and the height is actually the thickness of it. So we do need to make sure that we do have the appropriate formula and that we do know all the little pieces in order to plug into the formula. Otherwise, in order to calculate this, this would be the square root of 3 over 2 times side squared. So the side of this is 1 multiplied, and we need to make sure that we square that. And the height of this is going to be the thickness of it, which is actually 0.5. And we need to calculate this out. So when it comes to calculating this, we do need to follow the rules for order of operations, which tells us to take care of exponents first. In this particular case, though, it's just a 1, and 1 times a 1 is a 1. Otherwise, I would start with the square root of 3 over 2. So plugging that into your calculator, square root of 3 divided by 2 is approximately 0.866. And then we're multiplying that by 1 and multiplying that by 0.5. So that when we actually calculate this out, I'm getting 0.433, and this is centimeters cubed. So that gives us the volume of this entire figure here. So now step 2, we need to find the volume of this right circular, this right cylinder here, so that we can then remove that. So this formula here, so pi is 3.14. times the radius. So the radius here, so the radius is from the center of the circle out to the edge of it. If the entire diameter is 1, it says so right over here, that the entire diameter is 1, remember that the radius is the diameter divided by 2. So that would be 1 divided by 2, which is a 0.5, and we would square that. And we're going to multiply it by the height. So again, the height is the thickness of it, and that is also 0.5. So I'm going to go ahead and add that in over there. So order of operations tells us to take care of exponents first. So 0.5 times 0.5 is going to give us 0.25. And then we need to multiply that by 3.14 and multiply that by 0.5. So if we do times 3.14, and then times 0.5, we're getting that the volume of this right cylinder is 0.3925. So in order to find the volume of the hex nut, we need to take the volume of the hexagonal prism and subtract away the volume of the right cylinder. So if we take 0.433 minus 0.3925, the volume of our hex nut is 0.0405. Now this is the volume of one of these. Now what we're going to have to do with that volume is we are going to have to multiply it by the density of the weight here. So depending on what kind of material, so normally nuts are always some kind of metal. Depending on what kind of material it is, it's going to change the weight of it. So different metals, different materials weigh a different amount. So what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to take this 0.0405 and we're going to multiply it by the weight here. So we're going to say times 7.7112. And if we multiply that together, so 7.7112 times our volume, that would give us a total of 0.312 grams per centimeter cubed. So that means that one of these hex nuts weighs 0.312 grams per centimeter cubed. Now that's just the weight of one of them. Our problem wants to calculate the weight of 1,200 of these. So now what we need to do is we need to multiply by 1,200, keeping in mind that we do round to two decimal places here. So if we take the 0.312 times 1,200 of these, our grand total is 374.4 grams. So if we take the 0.312 grams that the hex nut weighs and multiply that by 1,200 of them, that is going to give us a grand total of 374.4 grams as the weight for 1,200 of these particular hex nuts. Otherwise, that is it for this video.